Hi, good afternoon. Thanks for tuning in. My name's Catherine Hankinson and I'm an Assistant Chief Constable with West Yorkshire Police. I'm responsible for safeguarding. And that's what I'm here to talk to you about this afternoon. Hopefully you've linked into some of the other things that have been ongoing throughout this safeguarding week. And I'm here to bring a close to that week and just to draw your attention to some of the key messages and some of the events that have been going on throughout this week. So at the beginning of the week, the Police and Crime Commissioner, alongside Superintendent Darren Minton, who's head of our safeguarding unit, spoke to you about a number of key messages that we wanted to get out during the week. But one of those, and probably the most important one, is that safeguarding is everyone's business. So whether you're a friend, a neighbour, a mum, dad, teacher, if you're concerned about somebody close to you, yourself, a neighbour, then please do ring us or let the most appropriate agency know. I just want to update you on some of the events that we've had ongoing across West Yorkshire and the different districts this week. So in Leeds, we've had an information session which concentrated on domestic abuse and human trafficking, trying to let people know what those things mean, what the kind of signs that you need to look out for and things you need to be concerned about with people that you know. In Wakefield, we had a public information day where we concentrated on talking about suicide prevention, mental health — it's been Mental Health Awareness Week as well this week — and also substance misuse issues, to try and help people understand what signs to look for in that respect. We've had a bit of fun as well. In Bradford earlier on in the week, we did safeguarding bingo to try and bring a little bit of fun and interaction, especially for some of the younger people, to describe some of the more serious messages around safeguarding and help people flag things that they need to be concerned about and aware about with their young people and friends. And then lastly, at Calderdale and Kirklees hospitals, we've had our safeguarding champions available there so that carers and patients can speak to them about any concerns that they might have and try and raise awareness about where to go to if you do have some of those concerns. So a really busy week, but just to reassure people that whilst this is safeguarding week, ordinarily across the force 24 hours a day, we do have patrol officers and neighbourhood officers who are really good at recognising the signs of vulnerability and really have a good understanding of safeguarding. On top of that, we have five districts and they each have a specific safeguarding unit. And they concentrate on some of the things with their specialist officers that I've mentioned already, such as domestic abuse and child sexual exploitation, forced marriage, just to mention a few. So I hope that some of the things that you've seen this week reassure you that West Yorkshire Police do take safeguarding vulnerable people really seriously, and that you can come to us and speak to us if you want to raise a concern about yourself or anybody else. Of course, you can ring us on 101 if that's the best thing for you to do. But if something is more imminent, if you think somebody's life's in danger or a crime's taking place at the moment, then don't hesitate to ring 999. Now, obviously, there'll be some people who may want to speak to somebody else before they might pluck up the courage to come to the police, and we understand that. So on our website, there are third sector organisations, charitable organisations, that people can go to for help and support before they might want to report it officially to a statutory body. I think that's all I need to say in closing this safeguarding week. I hope you found it really informative and helpful tuning in this week. Thanks very much for tuning in this afternoon.